Welcome back to Donkey Kong Country 3. The last video, yeah, we did Kong Fuse Cliffs. That was a pretty crazy level. I think this one is going to be a lot less crazy, but it's still a very interesting one. Let's head into Floodlit Fish. Okay, yeah, don't adjust your screens here. This is actually how dark the level is. Eventually, we're going to find On Guard. I think he's just down here. Okay, you can probably guess once you hit this glowing fish, it illuminates the area. Temporarily, though. So we're going to have to kind of move fast to see where we're going. I do know that this version, I mean, this level on the Game Boy Advance version is pretty different. I've seen a video of it a long time ago, and it you'll see when I get to it. Okay, but otherwise it's mostly a standard underwater level. This is like really the only main thing that, you know, that's different, I guess. But even then, like, you can actually navigate through here without the fish at all. It's just, you know, more annoying, I guess. Okay, I noticed there's like a split path here. Ooh. Oh, that led to the... Oh, okay. I wasn't sure if that would lead to, like, a bonus level or something. Let's hit him again. There we go. Alright, I need to be careful here. Just... The main thing I'm worried about in this level is just missing the bonus levels. It's so dark, I might, you know, not be able to see them. Ooh! Wait, what? What was I supposed to do there? Maybe I was supposed to go under them. I don't know. Great. I just talked about not wanting to get knocked out, but yeah, that's exactly what happened. Yeah, this music really fits this level, too. There we go. Okay, well, at least I know there's not really anything over here. I guess I can hit him again. I love the expression on their face when they get stabbed. It's pretty hilarious. Alright, this part right here isn't too bad. That part with the double... I think they're called Cocos. That surprised me a lot. I didn't think they would be moving that fast. Yeah, the red ones are the more dangerous ones. There we go. Actually, they weren't really moving that fast. Oops. Okay, I apologize in advance if it's hard to see the level on your screens here. Okay. You know, I probably shouldn't have taken those out. That was actually pretty dangerous. Yeah, I'll try to keep the level illuminated so everybody can see. Like I said, you can still see, hopefully, but if you have a monitor that's, like, pretty dark, then this isn't going to help with your viewing here. I click 90 stars. It's kind of a lot. It doesn't look like there's any enemies in here, it's just you're collecting 90 stars in the dark. Okay. Alright, hopefully I should be able to do this. I missed one. Okay, I think I got this. As long as I can find that coin. Oh, here it is. Good. Alright, that's bonus coin number 57, and we'll find 58 here in a bit, I guess. Actually, I haven't even found the checkpoint yet. Oh, this part is crazy. Okay. Oh, here it is. Ooh, these ones are moving now. Not really much of a difference there, it's just you might have to work a little bit harder to light up the levels in that case. Sneak past him. Or them. Okay, I got the end now. Whoa, it is... Oh, there you are. It's like, I know there's gotta be one around here somewhere. Yeah, there's different ways to go around here. I'm trying to make sure that I find what I'm looking for. Oh! Jeez. Oh, good. I gotta stop doing that. It's not safe. Yeah, that stinks. I got hit by one. They don't even. Well, that one was moving, so I guess in my defense, I got caught off guard. But yeah, not really ideal to get hit by those things. Ah. And this one wasn't even moving, jeez. Alrighty. I'm actually... I want to know what you guys think of the Game Boy Advance version once I start playing that. Is there something here? There's the G. I can't really see that well now, though. Oh, okay, that's what they were guarding, the bonus barrel. They're urchins here? Okay. No, they're... Alright, I gotta be careful getting in here then. Yes. That was pretty risky though. I thought I would get hit for sure. Now, I was kind of reluctant to do that, but I need to go here. Now, this one isn't bad. No enemies again. Well, at least I don't see any. No pun intended. There we go. Okay, so once we get to the end, that should be it. We just have to worry about Coin, but in these underwater levels, he's always like at the very end, like right before the goalpost. Okay, I don't want to get hit by him again. Whoa. Okay, these ones are actually moving, too. Very slowly, but... Gotta watch out for that. Okay, I hope I can get to Coin, because I might need Dixie Kong, too, but... Oh, okay. No, I got this. This is easy. Okay, and that's it. Very refreshing level compared to the last one. That last one was so annoying. Okay. It's like Pothole Panic. Oh, this... Okay, I remember this one too. That one's gonna be interesting. Okay, let's switch over to the Game Boy Advance version of Floodlit Fish now, and you can see what I've been talking about. Should be interesting. Alright, let's dive in. Yeah. If you notice, it's pretty dim here, but it's much, much brighter. So you actually don't even need to hit the fish. Let's do it for comparison's sake, though. Okay. Oh, wow, that's actually really bright. Well, actually, this is probably normal, but... Yeah, you don't need to hit any of those at all. You are perfectly fine. Even more so in the Super Nintendo version by... Ooh! Okay, that surprised me. Great. Anyway, yeah, you can just get by not hitting them at all, and I might do that because I seem to be getting hit by them a lot. Okay, let's go through here. I like how when you hit those and they deflate, you actually hear like a balloon popping noise. I don't know if it's just me, but it seems like there's more of those in this level. Oh! Shoot. You know, I'll be honest, I didn't even see that there. Look at that! Oh. Okay, the first time, that was on purpose. The second time, On Guard just auto-stabbed that thing. Okay. Stupid fish. They're trying to get revenge on me from the last time. Yeah, but yeah, other than the brighter level, I guess. Actually, in both cases, when you light up the level, it's way brighter. Other than that, and maybe the addition of more Cocos, this is pretty much the same level as before. Well, he's moving fast. Oof. Okay, maybe I should start avoiding those. I shouldn't have come this way either. I could have just avoided getting that O. Okay, I'm trying to swim carefully here. There we go. Nope. Oh wait, no. I forgot, I just realized that I'm supposed to go under them. Which actually seems pretty difficult because they're moving so fast. That's a good save though. Okay, they didn't come down here. I was very reluctant to go to this bonus barrel. I wasn't sure if they were still coming. Alright. So let's get the rest of these. Look how bright it is here. It's just... Actually, this was darkened in the Super Nintendo version. They just lit it up for you here. Nice. The layout's actually a little different too. Oops. There we go. That's number 57. Might as well. Whoa. Okay, I can't remember if I hit the continue barrel yet. I hope I did. But I don't remember doing it, so I probably didn't. Okay, I think it's right, yeah. It's right after the Barbos maze. Or not Barbos. Whatever those are called. Lurchin. There you go. Barbos is the boss of those. Ooh, it's a good thing I went over there. Oh! Whatever. So yeah, I should probably go for that N. I lost quite a few lives in Kong Fuse Cliff, so I'm trying to work my way back to getting the amount of extra lives I had before that. Okay, the bonus level isn't until towards the end, so not really missing anything by just kind of skipping through here. I do want to find a DK barrel, though. I kind of need one. Oh, there we go. Just what I needed. Ooh, that was close. Wait, there's another set here, too. Okay. Look at this thing right here. Probably gonna go around. Oh, no, I can't. It's weird, sometimes when you descend on enemies and do the stab move, you'll hit them, other times you won't. It's kind of annoying. Oh, wait. I want to wait for them to drop down a little bit. Oh, see, I took a risk there. I shouldn't have done that. Alright, let's try this part again. Oh. See, I'm going. I keep saying I'm not going to go for that anymore, but keep doing it anyway. Let's get these bear coins. Slowly build my way back up to 20 so I can buy that mirror back. Like I said, I don't have to do that anytime soon, but it's better to get that over with now. Okay. Whoa, okay, that was close. Okay, I thought I was gonna get hit by that. There's one more set. Yep. Good. I didn't get hit there. Now this is where the second bonus level is. Okay, I don't think I have to bother with that one. There we go. Alright, and once we get this done, we can head out of here. Then get the DK coin before we head out for good. Oh yeah, the next level, Pothole Panic, that one's another cave level, and then I actually can't remember what the level after that is. It's probably going to be another cliff, I would imagine. More ropes. Alright, and then the boss, of course. Then after that, I'm going to head to Pacifica in this version, and then the Super Nintendo version will be on break for a little bit until we catch up. Okay, I need to be careful at this part. Take that one out, it makes things a little bit easier. Okay, I ended up with Dixie Kong at the end of this version. Okay, I wasn't sure if I swam in. Another purple cave. Okay, that's it. Alright. Not a bad level. That one, it seemed actually a little bit more difficult on here just because, I don't know, I wasn't used to the lurchins being that fast. I don't know. They seem faster to me. Some of the enemies, not just the lurchins either. Okay. But yeah, I actually want to know what you think of that level too on both versions. But next up is Pothole Panic, and we'll get to that next. See you next time, everybody.